In this video, you will learn how to stop playing music on a certain slide in PowerPoint. Plus, you will also learn some other useful tricks related to adding music in PowerPoint. First of all, how do you insert music to your slides? It's very simple. You go to Insert and then go to Audio. Go to Audio on my PC. Since I have stored this audio on my PC, I'm going to select that option. And that opens up this dialog box. You can choose the place where you have stored your audio. Then say Insert and the audio is inserted. Then you go to Playback and choose the option called It Plays Automatically. Then if you want to play the music in the background, you choose Play in Background option. Now when I go to Slideshow, you can see that the music starts playing automatically and it continues to play even if I go to the next slide. So that is how you insert music that plays in the background for all slides in your presentation. The next question I get frequently asked is, what if I want to play the music only from the second slide onwards? It's ridiculously easy to do. I'll share that in a moment. But before that, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program, a comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program for professionals. If you want to play your music only from the second slide, all you need to do is to select the audio, cut it, go to the second slide and paste it, and then without forgetting, you need to select this, go to Playback and once again hit Play in Background. Sometimes PowerPoint can act quite weird and may not play your music from the second slide unless you hit this icon once again. Now let us go to Slideshow and you can see that on the first slide there is no music being played. And the moment I go to the second slide, you can see that the music automatically starts. And it'll continue to play for the rest of the slide deck. So you can start your music pretty much from any slide you want. All you need to do is to go to that specific slide and insert the music and hit Play in Background icon. Now, the next and the most important question is, how do I stop playing music on a particular slide? Now, take a look at this deck. I have 7 slides in total, but on the 4th slide, I have a video here, which has its own audio. So I don't really want this background music to continue to play on this slide as well. So how do I ensure that the music stops on this slide? I'll show you 2 scenarios. Let us say you have your audio icon inserted onto the first slide, which is usually the case, and we go to Playback and hit Play in Background. Now the music will play in the background for the entire slide deck. But then on the 4th slide, I don't want the music to play. So I go to the Animations tab, click on Animation Pane so you can see all the animations here. Then select the animation for that specific audio piece. And then click on the drop-down menu and then say Effect Options. Here you can see the command of where the music needs to start from, and that is from beginning. And more importantly, we have this option where we can determine where the music stops playing. In this case, I want the music to stop playing after 3 slides. So let me go here and say 3 and say OK. Now the music will stop after 3 slides. Let us see. So we have the first slide, then we have the second slide, then we have the third slide, and then when I click and go to the next slide, you can see that the music has stopped and the video has its own audio, so that will start playing. Now in this case, I don't really have any audio on this particular video, but if you do have, then that audio will play from this video. Now, let me tell you the common mistake people make in deciding after which slide the music needs to stop. Now, let us assume that instead of the first slide, I want to have the music start from the second slide. As I told you earlier, you paste your audio on the slide you want to select and then you go to Playback and hit Play in Background. Now, to stop music after slide number 3, what people would do is to go here, go to Effect Options and say, stop playing after slide number 3. So that is what they assume that this is, and say OK. Now when I go to Slideshow, you can see that the music is playing here on this slide, and this is the second slide, and then this is the third slide, and then when I go to the next slide, you can see that the music continues to play, and only after that slide the music has stopped. The reason is you need to understand what is actually written here, which is after these number of slides. You can see that we only have two slides after which the music needs to stop, and we have entered three, assuming that this is the number that we need to input here. No. You need to start counting from the slide that has the audio and count the number of slides. Here, there are only two slides, and therefore I'm going to say two slides and say okay. Now, when I go to slideshow, we have the music playing automatically, and then we have the next slide playing, and then on a click we have no music happening, and that is because we instructed PowerPoint to stop after two slides. I highly recommend that you join our Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program, which is a useful course for anyone who is a professional and needs to make presentations as part of their profession. The link to this product is in the description box below. In the meantime, do you want to learn some simple and creative PowerPoint ideas you can use in your next presentation? Then click on the link here to join our 5-day free email course called 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas. These are simple, quick, and useful PowerPoint ideas I have not shared elsewhere. So go ahead, click on the link, join the course, and I will see you inside.